Today, guys, I finally decided to drag out my Yamaha blaster and fix it up because it was running very poorly last time I drove it, which was probably in like August of 2019. So it sat for a few months now. I don't really show it as much in the videos. You guys probably, most of you didn't even know I had this four-wheeler, but this is mine. I ride it occasionally in the summertime. I paid originally like $280. I'll give you guys the story on it. I paid $280 for it, blown up probably a year and a half ago, 2 years ago almost. It had a lot of sand up in the top end, and I could see the air filter was just completely full of sand. So I think, and he had no air box lid, I don't think. So I'm pretty sure he just had dirt ingestion, and it ate away the rings and kind of didn't seize it up, but it just lost compression. So I ended up rebuilding it, and then I got it all rebuilt top end wise, and I put it back together, got it in, and then I noticed that I had like a crankcase leak between the seams of the cases. So I pulled the motor back out again, rebuilt, put all new crank seals in the bottom end, took it all apart, put a brand new clutch in it as well while I was in there, resealed the crankcases, and then I put it back together, and it was running okay. And it was good for a while, but it just never ran really good. Like, I've ran a few good blasters, and this just didn't have the power. And it was kind of sputtery, and it just didn't run very good. So I tried messing with, like, different needles in the different jet needles in the throttle area under the throttle cap there. I put an aggressive needle in it because I thought I was running lean. I'll show you the needle I put in it. I put in that guy. It's got a really aggressive taper at the end, so it was a super rich needle. I even tried with the leanest position, and it just wouldn't work. So I must have had too much fuel, and I needed to go leaner. And then I was messing. Here's another carburetor I have. I have, like, I don't know how many carburetors for these blasters. But here's a stock carb, and I was looking at the float height. And usually floats, you know, parallel with the gasket surface is usually good. And the one that was on my blaster was, like, I'll show you guys. It was, like this. It was sitting like that. So I set it so it was a little bit more level. And I was also missing a brass washer in the main jet area, guys. And I found one, luckily, off this old Yamaha Warrior carburetor here. Even though I think it's a Kian, might be, it still had the washer, and it actually fit in the area that I needed. So that was good. And I also put a 240 main jet. I have all kinds of jets from like 220 to 300. So I put a 240 because I do have an FMF pipe. Full FMF pipe on it, so I figured it probably should go up one size. I think 230 is stock after 1989. 1988 and 89 had 220 main jet stock, and then 89 and up had 230 main jet, so I went up one size to a 240, which I think is safe enough. I also, with that stock needle, I went up one clip position, so I leaned it out just a little bit from the third position, which is usually stock. And I started it up earlier, and it seemed to run pretty good, guys. It leaked fuel out of the overflow right away, which is weird because it's like I set the float how it should be set, parallel, and it just leaked. So I started up with the gas off, and I turned the gas on while it was running, and it didn't leak out any fuel while it was running. It actually ran really good. And when it gets nicer, right now, guys, we just got a huge snowstorm. I wouldn't say a huge snowstorm, but we had like 6-8 inches, and then we just got dumped with another 4 or 5. So my yard is not plowed out yet. You can see the snowmobiles are just... I just uncovered them. They were kind of buried from the snow we got last night. But I'll get some running footage of this thing and possibly some riding clips with my tripod, and I'll include them at the end of the video for you guys. But yeah, I kind of got it running pretty good. I started up this morning before I started recording this video, and it actually ran really well, a lot better than it's ran in the past. Probably wouldn't hurt to maybe I'll throw a new spark plug in and another BR80S. I put a new fuel line on it, new overflow line down there. I have my pilot air screw set at one turnout. Maybe I'll fine-tune it eventually. But at least it seems to be working properly for the most part. Probably could use a fuel line clamp on there. But yeah, that's basically what I did to it. I was sick of sitting. It was sitting back there, guys. You can see where it was. It was sitting there since August. Haven't started. It started 2 kicks, guys. 2 kicks sat since August. So the motor's definitely very strong. Everything, it seems healthy on it. My pipe is kind of loose.
It doesn't fit the best.
Like I was saying, guys, I'm not going to be able to ride the blaster until it gets a little bit warmer. Yesterday it was like close to, I don't know, 10 degrees in the morning or something like that. Today it was 0 degrees Fahrenheit, and tomorrow it's going to be super cold. So I'm not going to be starting the blaster until probably 2 or 3 days from now. And then I'll get some riding footage and a startup in another video. But this is basically just going over how I fixed the blaster, and it's definitely running a lot better. So we'll get some footage of it riding when the weather warms up to at least like 20 degrees or 30 degrees. I'm not starting this thing when it's 0 degrees. And I definitely don't want to ride in that either, because I got to get in like a snowmobile suit, face mask, the whole works, just so I can ride and not die. So other than that, she is pretty decent. Give you guys some more shots of it. It's not perfect by any means. 1997, like I said. It's got DG nerfs on it. Rear brake delete. Stuff like that. The pipe is definitely dented in the back. Front tires are bald and they lose air over time. The rears have really good tread, but they also lose air over time. It's running 32:1 premix, so that's about it, guys. Make sure you leave a like on the video if you enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. We'll see you guys next time.